Hi, I'm Diane Prusch with Pilates Center of Bend. Welcome to the CoreCast. Sorry it's been a couple weeks. I've been out sick, but I'm feeling much better. Today we're going to be focusing on chest lift and chest lift with rotation. I received an email from Uma asking for some information on the basics of Pilates, and I received an email from Tilly asking for some ab exercises. So I think with this episode we should be able to cover both of those. With chest lift and chest lift with rotation, you want to engage your abs. This is an ab exercise. The abs that I really want you to focus on are the ones below the belly button, the TA. These abs are used in almost all of the Pilates exercises. That's what you really want to pull in to stabilize your core and develop that core strength. These exercises also focus on the abs that are a little bit higher up, the ones that people call the six-pack abs. So we'll be working on those as well. If you want to develop those muscles, this is the exercise for you. To do chest lift and chest lift with rotation, lay down on your mat with your legs 2 to 4 inches apart or hip joint distance apart, arms down by your sides and your pelvis in a neutral position. Neutral means you're not arched in the lower back and you're not completely flat on the mat, somewhere in between. Reach your arms up towards the ceiling, interlace your fingers, bring your hands behind your head. You take an inhale to prepare and pull your lower abs, the ones below the belly button, pull them down as far as you can. Lift the head and the chest. Pause at the top with an inhale and exhale to lower yourself all the way down. You'll notice that I'm keeping my arms wide. I'm not pulling my elbows in towards my chest or towards my knees when I do the chest lift. They're staying right where they are. You don't want to jut your chin up towards the ceiling. You want to keep your chin fairly close to your chest as you're doing this to keep the back of your neck long. A little tip to help you remember this is to imagine that there is a tangerine between your chin and your chest, and you don't want to lift your chin, otherwise the tangerine will go rolling, and you don't want to bring your chin too close to your chest or you'll have orange juice. So a nice even head position. Once you've done 10 reps of chest lift, you'll come back up to the same starting position for chest lift with rotation. Your hands are still behind your head. You lift your upper body. You take an inhale there, and then as you exhale, you reach your shoulder towards the opposite knee. Not the elbow, the shoulder. Inhale to cross center and exhale, reach with the shoulder. My pelvis stays in neutral, my abs are in. Don't make this movement just with your arms and your neck. Make sure the movement is happening at the waist, as if your waist was a wet towel and you're wringing out the water. The focus is the obliques, the abs on the sides of your body, so you want to focus on that, feel those working as you do chest lift with rotation. I hope you enjoyed learning about chest lift and chest lift with rotation. You should definitely be feeling your abs by now. I would love to hear from you on our new forum at www.pilatescenterofbend.com. Thanks, see you next time.